Well, good evening, People's Church, Newton Abbey, and brothers and sisters around the province, around the nation, and even around the world. Thank you for tuning in and joining us on our Christmas carol service. I want to thank everybody who's helped to put this night together online. So let's sit back, enjoy the Christmas carol service at the People's Church, Newton Abbey. Jesus is the reason for the season.
Lay down his sweet head. Became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Tonight, we tell a Christmas story, a true story of God who used ordinary people for extraordinary purpose. Tonight, join with us as PCN Glow present the Bethlehem News.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to tonight's Bethlehem News. I'm Jamie, and here are tonight's headlines. No room in the inn due to current lockdown restrictions. Space is limited as government cracks down on numbers allowed day during the census. Chief medical officers ask, should donkeys be made to wear masks? We will debate this with the experts. A well is almost dry in a small suburb. due to excessive hand washing. A new baby born causes quite the excitement in a stable in the city. And that is where we will begin our coverage tonight with our correspondent live at the scene. Tell us the latest, Robin.
Thanks, Tom. I'm here tonight with the proud father who has caused some controversy. So, Joseph, you've travelled from Nazareth. So, what has brought you here to our city?
As you know, many have travelled to the city due to the census decreed by Caesar Augustus. Many of my people have been living and working in Nazareth, but as I am a descendant from King David, I had registered here in the city, myself and my wife.
You mentioned your wife. Wasn't there some scandal around this pregnancy?
When Mary found out that she was expecting a child, we were engaged to be married. As you can imagine, it did cause quite a stir in the community and within the church.
As would be the norm in these circumstances, you could have left the marriage. Can you explain to us why you chose not to?
Well, I had intentionally thought that that would be the best thing, but God had other plans. In my dreams, an angel came and told me that Mary was carrying a child conceived of the Holy Spirit and that it was a boy and I was to call him Jesus because he would save our people from their sins.
And you believed that?
God has often spoken to his children via dreams. So yes, I believed and I knew once I spoke with Mary that this was the truth.
Thank you, Joseph. Now back to Jamie in the studio.
Thanks, Robin. News just in. We have the innkeeper who had the birth in his stable talking to us live. How are you feeling having the baby born in your stable?
I'm a bit embarrassed, but it's all I could offer. And I could see the poor girl was ready to drop. We had made it warm and comfortable as possible. I'd never dreamed that she would give birth there.
Have you managed to get a nurse of the new arrival?
We've been so busy here. There's been a lot of interest in this little one. And the stable hasn't stopped. I have a feeling this child is going to be something very special. I've had a sneak peek and he is a beautiful baby.
A baby born in a stable conceived of the Holy Spirit during this time. Who would have believed it? Who would believe it? I'm hearing more commotion at the inn, Robin. Who have you there with you now?
Hi, I have the shepherds here who are usually quite busy in the fields this time of year. Can you tell us what you're doing here in the city?
Okay, shall I go first or you? No, you go. Okay, well, I'll go. We were out in the fields and this light just lit up the sky. It nearly blinded us. I fell on top of him. I was petrified. Then there was the most amazing voice from heaven. It sounded like a choir. They sounded amazing. I still wasn't for looking up. Not that everything seems these days. I thought we were going to die. But then the most amazing thing happened. Angels appeared and told us not to be afraid. They told us this baby would be born and he would save us. And he was in the manger in a stable in Bethlehem. We must go. We were definitely for going. Finally, the promised one was coming and God allowed us shepherds, nobodies, to hear first. In fact, he sent a message to us direct from heaven because our God thought we were worthy. Well, we couldn't wait to find the child. And when we saw him, something happened with our hearts. We knew this was God's promised one. His parents were lovely and welcomed us. He was beautiful. It is important to let you know this baby will not only bring joy to us, but to all people. He is the savior of the world.
This is getting stranger by the second. We now have angels from the heavenlies declaring this birth. I have one question. How did you know where to find him?
We saw a star. It was huge. It was the brightest we had ever seen. We headed towards it and we found where it stood, top of the stables where Jesus was.
Amazing. So folks, that is the breaking news. A new baby Jesus born today in our humble city, healed by the angels, and who is the saviour of the world. This has caused some excitement in our city and beyond. We would like to wish Mary, Joseph, and the child every blessing for the future and look forward to the joy this baby will bring to all of us, not just here in Bethlehem, but around the world. This is truly prophecy fulfilled before our eyes.
Isaiah 7, verse 14. Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel, which means God be with us.
Before we turn to our less exciting news, here's the weather where you are.
Thanks, folks. What amazing news. Well after the star disappears in the east, we will see the sun rising. It will bring rays of joy and a peaceful front will emerge that will extend throughout all the regions.
Luke chapter 2, verse 17 to 20. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Shepherds kept their watching over silent flocks by night. Behold, throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angels' chorus that hailed our Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Down in a lonely manger, our humble Christ was born. Sent us salvation that blessed Christmas morn. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. That Jesus Christ is born.
Sun is gone. that properly fits every heart. And it's with this love that all celebrations start. We rejoice in him as we remember his birth.
Thank you, God, for sending your only son to earth.
See you for the child born that night to be our light.
Ages for Herod, whose murderous scheme was told to Joseph in the nocturnal dream.
R is for rejoice with gladness and joy.
I is for Emmanuel, God with us.
S is for the star, what led the wise men to him.
T is for the truth and grace that was sent our way.
M is for Mary, his mother so brave, counting God faithful and mighty to save.
A is for the angels appearing so bright, telling of Jesus at first Christmas night.
S is for Saviour, to be this he came.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Saviour who is Christ the Lord.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Before the lowly bed.
What a saviour. What a great night we have had. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm sure you'll agree with me that we're so thankful to everyone who took part tonight in this Christmas Carol Service 2020. At this time, in this year of all years, but we can still praise the Lord. The Lord has done something. Hallelujah. Christ has come. The Lord has come. And we are just rejoicing in that tonight. That's what this is all about this evening. Just celebrating the fact that God has stepped in, that the Lord has done something. And the Lord bless you tonight for tuning in. I just want to read a verse to you that to bring to a close this wonderful service tonight. Isaiah chapter 9 and verse number 6. Here's the promise of God, foretold hundreds of years before Jesus was even born. Listen to what God said through the prophet Isaiah. For unto us a child is born, for unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. One verse tonight. Come on, we'll pray that God will bless it to our hearts. Lord, again, thank you for tonight. Thank you for everyone who has taken part, from the youngest through, Lord, to the oldest. And we thank you for all the leaders tonight and their contribution with the children and young people. Bless them, Lord. Keep them together and keep them safe, Lord, even at this time. But we ask you, Lord, for what we've just read, will you bless it to our hearts? And will you glorify again the wonderful name of Jesus? Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, this verse that we have just read tonight is a promise of a Redeemer, of one sent who would become the Savior. And the first thing it says about him is this: his name will be called Wonderful. His name will be called Wonderful. Unto us a child is born. That's what Isaiah said. Unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Isn't that amazing? With many in our society, and regarding many in our society, the name of Jesus is anything but wonderful. With many today, his name is mocked, his name is misused, his name is blasphemed and brought low by so many in our society today. But Christian believers throughout the course of time and in all generations, from every race and tongue on the planet, have felt the same way this man Isaiah felt all those years ago. The name and person of Jesus Christ is just wonderful. And that's what we're saying tonight as a church. That's what the people of the People's Church, Newton Abbey, are saying tonight through this service, through all that we have been producing tonight. We're doing it for a reason, to lift up the wonderful name of Jesus. I just want to leave you with the question, just one question tonight before we close, and we're not going to go on too long. This is not a big preach, but just one question to think about. What's so wonderful about the name of Jesus? What's so wonderful about Jesus? Now think about that. And when you think about it, contemplate this. What makes an estimated 2.6 billion people on the planet today believe and trust in the name of Jesus? And many of them are following him fully. What makes someone put their life at risk just to worship him? Because you need to know this. Even right now, today, many, many people are putting themselves at risk just to go to places to worship Jesus and to pray to him with all of their heart. And many of them are losing their lives in doing that. What makes someone do that? Why is Jesus so wonderful to people that they'll even put their lives in jeopardy for his name's sake? What's so wonderful about Jesus? Well, here's just a few things to think about before we close that makes Jesus wonderful. And to me, these few things combined just go a long way to underline to us, to educate us, why Jesus Christ is so wonderful. Think about this first of all. His birth was wonderful. Now, it really was. So many parts to it. So much contributing to the birth of Jesus Christ. On one level, it's simple. On another level, it's incredibly detailed and incredibly deep. Every part of the birth of Jesus Christ was wonderful. Heralded centuries before it even happened. Prophesied, promised, hundreds of years by various people under God, foretold and promised hundreds of years before it even happened. Promised from heaven, and that promise was wonderfully fulfilled. Bypassing the wise and the noble, God chooses a humble couple full of believing faith, and through them, God sends his gift of a Savior to the world. And I tell you tonight, that was wonderful. Listen to what the Bible says, Galatians 4 and verse 4. But when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law. That was wonderful. When the fullness of the time, everything knit together, everything came together that night at Bethlehem in a moment, a God moment, a God-ordained moment in a wonderful way. And Jesus, the Savior of the world, was born. The wonder of wonders, the creator of the universe, lay in a stable. That's the wonder tonight, the wonder of his birth. And I tell you what the wonder is today as well, why he would even think of us in the first place. He should have left us to our own devices. He should have left us to perish, but he didn't. God sent his best. He gave us everything when he gave us Jesus. And that's the wonder tonight, the wonder of Jesus. And people have rejected him. And that's a wonder too, that they would reject such grace and reject such amazing grace. And yet people do reject it. And that is a wonder. And they still do today. There was no room for him over 2,000 years ago. And there's still no room for him today in many, many lives and in many, many hearts. And yet in grace and mercy, he still comes to people. He pleads with people. No one else would do it, but he does it. And that's what makes him wonderful tonight. The wonder of his birth, but also the wonder of his life. Because you need to remind yourself of this. When Jesus lived that life on earth, it was wonderful what he did. The impact he had on people could only be described as wonderful. And here's what Jesus said in Mark 10 and verse 45. For even the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his own life a ransom for many. Notice the words there, serve and give, serve and give. And throughout Jesus's life, for those 33 and a half years, he just done that, served and gave, day on day, week on week, time on time. And that's what Jesus done constantly. And when he done it, he made a difference in people's lives. Listen, he made a wonderful difference in people's lives. Touching them, healing them, saving them. And it was wonderful. The wonder of his life. And here's something else that's wonderful. Here's something else tonight that's truly wonderful. He's still making that difference tonight. He's still making that difference now in a wonderful way. Even the people of our church, testimonies, personal testimonies. Someone just texted us during the week saying about the change in their life from this time last year when Jesus came to them and changed them in a wonderful way. Where they were last year, this time last year, to where they are tonight, notwithstanding the pandemic, the change in them is truly wonderful. That's what Jesus does, and that's what makes him wonderful. But listen, his death was wonderful too. And it's strange to say that, but it was. Because that's what Jesus came to do. He came to die. Serve and give, he said, and to give his life a ransom for many, Jesus said. His death was wonderful because he gave up his own life. He laid it down freely of himself. And what wonderful love and grace and mercy is involved in that. The Apostle Paul could say this. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. And that's what we're remembering tonight at this Christmas time, that Christ Jesus came into the world. And we could ask, well, why did he come into the world? All sorts of reasons could be given, but Paul tells us simply, he came into the world to save sinners. Oh, through his dying on the cross, that was accomplished. By the way, that includes us all tonight. Because the Bible says there's no difference, because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. The punishment for our defiance and the breach of God's laws was put upon Jesus at his death. He took it, he paid for it, and today freedom and forgiveness is ours, and that's wonderful. That's the most wonderful thing in life. The wee song says, his dying breath has brought me life. I know it is finished. That's a wonderful reality to have tonight. And we could ask, what's so wonderful about Jesus? All of these things make him wonderful. But he didn't say, I am finished. God kept his word. God kept his promise. And we rejoice because of the wonder of his resurrection as well. That was wonderful. That Jesus rose from the dead, just like he promised. He says, take this life and I will raise it up again. And that happened. And here's what Jesus said in the last book of the Bible. In Revelation chapter 1 and verse 18, I am he who lives and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. What a wonderful declaration. Listen, this is what makes Jesus wonderful tonight. What's so wonderful about Jesus? Everything is wonderful about him. But if you thought his birth, his life, his death, and resurrection are wonderful, let me leave you with this thought. Wait till you see what he does with you. Wait till you see the wonderful change he'll bring about in you if you will let him. You can hear about the wonder of Jesus, but there's nothing like experiencing it in your own heart, in your own life. And that can happen tonight at this Christmas time, when the world is darker than ever before, when people feel that darkness of despair and depression and discrepancy on a level like never before. Let his light shine on you. Open your life for that light to come in. And I'm telling you something tonight, you will experience something wonderful, because there's no one like Jesus. We have enjoyed tonight. We have laughed tonight at those children. Aren't they brilliant? Weren't they wonderful? Thank God for all the leaders who put it together. And we're praying for them all at this time. But you know something? We want to leave you with this invitation to come to Jesus if you haven't yet, to experience the wonder of him for yourself. We're going to end with a prayer, and a prayer that is in essence an opportunity. I want to pray it. I'll pray a line, and then you can pray the line if you don't know the Lord tonight. But this is a wonderful opportunity, by the way. Oh, if you don't know the Lord, take it as we pray right now. Come on, let's just pray as we end this evening. Will you pray this from your heart? Lord, I come to you just as I am. You know me, but yet you love me. And I need you tonight. I need you for myself. I need to experience the wonder of you in me. Lord, will you forgive me? Forgive my sins. Will you cleanse me? Will you change me in a wonderful way? Will you change my desires even? I come to you. I give myself to you. And I believe you tonight. Hear my prayer. Hear my call. I want to know the full wonder of you working in my life in a wonderful way. Will you do it, Lord? May I see it. May others see it. And may you get the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you so much for tuning in this evening. Just want to remind you, we're back again tomorrow night for the weekly call to prayer. We know it's Christmas week, but we've got to keep praying. We've got to keep calling on God, especially at the minute. So we're excited about tomorrow night meeting up again. Will you come back, brothers and sisters from the People's Church? And we're meeting back on Christmas Eve, Thursday night in the car park. Not Wednesday night this week, but Thursday night on Christmas Eve at 7 o'clock in the car park. Will you phone Kelly from tomorrow? Book your place for Thursday night. But the Lord bless you this week. May you have a wonderful Christmas because of a wonderful Jesus. God bless you. Amen.